In this devotional, I'm going to share with you three thoughts from Matthew chapter 3, verses 7 through 12, where I'll ask the question, what did John tell the Pharisees? Matthew chapter 3, verses 7 through 12 says, "But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees coming to his baptism, he said to them, 'You brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bear fruit in keeping with repentance, and do not presume to say to yourselves, "We have Abraham as our father." For I tell you, God is able from these stones to raise up children for Abraham. Even now, the axe is laid at the root of the trees. Every tree, therefore, that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. I baptize you with water for repentance, but he who is coming after me is mightier than I, whose sandals I am not worthy to carry. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand, and he will clear his threshing floor and gather his wheat into the barn, but the chaff he will burn up with unquenchable fire." John the Baptist was remarkably popular, and his popularity stems from a couple different things. He was weird, and being weird kind of draws a crowd because people want to go and see the weird guy who's out there in the wilderness calling people to repentance. But also, the things that he was saying rang true. And when somebody says something and it's true, it has a certain sound to it. The truth sounds different from the lies that many other people are saying. So as John is out there being kind of weird and speaking the truth, he gathers this big crowd of people around him, so many that even the religious leaders come to see what's going on with John the Baptist. So here are three thoughts from Matthew chapter 3, verses 7 through 12, answering the question, what did John tell the Pharisees? Thought number one, warning of wrath. John tells the Pharisees when they come to see him, that wrath is coming. And not only is wrath coming, but wrath is coming for the likes of them. He tells them very specifically that, I'm surprised you're here. I'm surprised that somebody even warns you of the wrath that is coming. I'm surprised that you even recognize the fact that you need repentance. Because after all, John's whole message is that people need to repent because the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So the first thing that John says when he sees the scribes, the Pharisees, the teachers of the law coming toward him, he says, "You brood of vipers, who warned you of the wrath to come?" So John's warning was one of wrath. He tells the Pharisees that wrath is coming, and it's coming specifically for people like them who multiply the burdens upon the people. Thought number two, bear fruit. What John tells them is that they need to bear fruit, and when they bear fruit, they need to bear fruit in keeping with the repentance that he's telling them they need to exercise. He's telling them that it isn't enough for you just to give lip service and come and be baptized by the weirdo out here in the wilderness, but instead, they actually have to live out this repentance. They need to demonstrate that their repentance wasn't just a matter of lip service, but that they really are repenting of the fact that they had heaped heavy burdens upon the people, that they had expected more than God himself even expected of the people of Israel. John tells the Pharisees that they need to bear fruit in keeping with repentance. They need to actually repent and not just say that they're repenting of their sins. They need to actually change their ways and demonstrate that in their everyday life. And if they don't do that, then the only thing that they have coming for them is wrath. Thought number three, coming harvest. Ultimately, John is talking about the coming of Christ. He is saying that after him, somebody is coming who is much more powerful than he. He is saying and is very upfront about the fact that he is not the Messiah, but that the Messiah is coming. And when the Messiah comes, he's going to come in power and in might, and he is coming to harvest. And he makes this point that when the Messiah comes, and the Messiah comes to harvest, that his winnowing fork is in his hand, that he is going to harvest all of the wheat, and he's going to separate the wheat from the chaff. And the wheat he takes in to the barn to be stored, and the chaff, what happens? He burns it up. Do you get what John is saying here? He's saying that you're one of these things or the other. You are either the wheat or the chaff. And we know from the context that you can demonstrate that you are the wheat by bearing fruit in keeping with repentance, the same repentance that John is preaching about, the same repentance that we all need to exercise because we recognize that the kingdom of heaven is at hand. It was at hand in John's day. It's at hand today. The kingdom of heaven, I would even say, is here and now. Therefore, we have to repent because the harvest looms on the horizon. Christ has his winnowing fork in his hand, and he will separate the wheat from the chaff. So demonstrate repentance. Be ushered into the barn with the wheat and escape the fire that cannot be quenched. These three thoughts come from the assigned reading of Matthew chapters 3 and 4. If you'd like to read through the Bible with me, you can do so by subscribing to this channel, by clicking on the link in the description, or by joining the Facebook group Through the Bible, where we are reading the text of Scripture together.